Be strong. We are not here to play, dream, or drift. We have hard work to do and loads to lift. Shun not the struggle. Face it, for it is God's gift. Be strong. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I am Al Austin, Charlotte City Councilman for District 2. I'm up for re-election this year and ask for your vote and support. When the members of District 2 asked me to serve for them, I committed that I would take care of home, which is my district and the city of Charlotte. And I've done that very well. I've been resourceful, I've been responsive, I've been reliable. I've been responsive in the sense that I'm probably the only city councilman that set up weekend hours. I've got hours on Saturdays and Sundays, so you, the community, can come and talk with me. I've been resourceful. When you have a problem, I like to join in with you in that problem and try to resolve it. And reliable, I show up, I'm prepared, I'm on time, and I get it done. I ask for your support. I'm Al Austin, Charlotte City Council, District 2.
Good morning, everyone. I'm LaJuan Mayfield. When I was first elected in 2011, I came from a community organizing background. I worked in this community for more than 20, 25 years, working on immigration reform, alternatives to incarceration, working with the homeless community, really building relationships specifically with our undocumented Latino community, as well as African community, because we were seeing a lot of people, especially after Hurricane Katrina, moving into the area, building relationships and trying to make sure that we had a better opportunity, because I grew up in South Florida. So when I moved here in 88, Charlotte was very much black and white. So now when you look at the city that we're in today in 2015, we have a 10% Asian Pacific Islander population. In my district, which represents Southwest Charlotte, of which all of you should have, or if you don't, I can make sure you get this wonderful little map, which was something when I first elected, I created, because we hear a lot about what's not happening on the west side, what we don't have on the west side. I needed people to change that dialogue. Instead of looking at a glass half empty, we need to look at that glass half full and recognize there's a lot of resources, but there's more that could be done. So when I created this asset map in collaboration with the City of Charlotte staff, this gave a very visual impact for the community. When I look at my role as a representative, I look at that as an advocate. We're public servants, and we can't forget that. So we're thinking of being a public servant. Since I've been in council for only 3.5 years, we now have the Charlotte Premium Outlet, which is the first and only actual outlet in the city of Charlotte. That was the first project that I worked on in 2012. Goodwill Opportunity Campus, a $28 million project that's coming on Wilkinson Boulevard, giving even further development on the west side. You have lots of new businesses, dimensional partners, advisor partners coming in South End. We have the VA facility that's off of Tybola. We have UTC Aerospace. I voted against it in council for the simple fact that if you're a multi-billion dollar business, I think you don't need tax dollars to help encourage you to come in the area you're already going to come, but they still chose District 3 in order to set up. We also have sealed air. We have a lot of development in South End when you look at the growth that's happening. The role that I play as that advocate is to be that champion on council, not just for the district, but for the entire city. Because my vote, along with five of my colleagues, we're creating policy for the city. When I ran, it was on a promise of stable, smart, and strong. Stable property values, smart economic development, and strong community safety. I show up in the community. If any of you follow me on social media, you would clearly see that I'm constantly at a community cleanup, I'm at a community meeting, I'm shoulder to shoulder with my neighbors, not necessarily just always sitting in the office. My pseudo office in the community is the Show Mars on Freedom Drive, because I live off of Freedom. So on the west side, that's where you can usually find me in the mornings or in the evenings, is at that Show Mars, because it's a great place. With that, I ask for your support. Mayfield for District 3.
I'm from District 5. District 5 is mostly East Charlotte. And East Charlotte has fallen on some really tough times as far as economic development goes. We have 106,000 residents, but only 16,000 jobs. But we have 54% employment. So that means District 5 citizens are traversing the streets of the city and the county to move to other parts of the city and county to earn a living. That's an unsustainable situation. It increases congestion on our roads, hurts our air quality, puts the extra burden on that family for that person who's away from their family while they're making that commute, and then the cost of owning and maintaining a car in good condition to make that commute. Those who live in District 5 feel like they're not being paid attention to. But I'm here today to tell you that that's not the case. because to not pay attention to a part of the city that has fallen on tough times is not good business, because that's unsustainable, because we cannot continue to rely on the southern wedge from Center City down into the Ballantyne area for most of the city's resources. That is absolutely unsustainable. The biggest thing that we have to worry about is to, like my colleague said, the glass is half full, not half empty. We have a lot that we should be exploiting and making better for. The immigrant community has come along Central Avenue and revitalized that area. I defy anybody to go down Central Avenue and find two commercial properties next to each other that are vacant. It just isn't happening. But we need to celebrate that success and those wins. We're looking forward to the opening of Meridian Place on Road across from East Meck. That'll be the first mixed-use development in District 5. And we're working hard on the plan for the redevelopment of the Eastland property. Yes, the film studio commitment did not pan out, but it was a good thing to look at and spend the time to fully vet that project to see that it wasn't going to happen the way everybody was telling us it was going to happen. That's being good stewards of the city's money. We do have a plan that is going to put a K-8 magnet school on the property back facing towards the Lower Lakes neighborhood. That is the first step in getting that property redeveloped, because we know that schools can be attractors, and a magnet school especially is a good attractor. We've got to build critical mass on the east side with people who have disposable income. We've got an open-air market that has taken root on the eastern property on Saturdays and Sundays. A couple of entrepreneurs have set up shop over there. We had 91 vendors this last Saturday. That's an open-air market, sort of a Central America, South America flavor to it. But folks, it is a vibrant opportunity to show the private sector that people can show up, people will spend their money, they'll have a good time, they'll go home, and they'll come back and tell their friends about it. I'm John Autry, Charlotte City Council, District 5. District 5 is the most important district in the city because it's in the east, and that's where the sun comes up every morning over the city.
For those who don't know me, my name is Scott Derrick Jenkins. I'm a current City of Charlotte employee, and I run for Charlotte City Council District 5. I live in the East. I have two children in Title I school, so I understand all the challenges that we face. My main focus is jobs, affordable housing, transportation. That police substation needs to be built there in the East Lamar site. I gave the rate. What the investors have told me, that if we can get it to where people can come and enjoy the day with their families, that police station is vital to getting it built there. We need Eastern Mall to be an entertainment destination for our families once again, like the East used to be. We want other people to be coming here and have a good time with their families as well. We need to strengthen our small business. We need to work closely with CMS to get these kids off the street, some after-school programs, get some more mentorships, and get a better partnership with our partners and all the investors that got a stake in the East Side. The time is now. We can't wait any longer for East Side to continue to fall behind other parts of the city. We know the numbers are staggering. We need to turn this around. We need new leadership, and that's why I'm running to make a difference. We need help now. There's no more time to wait. I'm asking for your support to help me help you make a better East Charlotte, and perhaps help the West as well, because those are the two areas of our city that are hurting the most. So please, look at the candidates, hold them to it. Accountability, accessibility, availability. Keep in contact with everybody and let them know what's going on in the community, and make sure we get the positives out in the news on the good things that are happening on the East and the West. Thank you for your support.